Across Honduras, out in the countryside, where dirt roads snake through forests and tiny towns, locals are raising a special crop. It's not beans, or papayas, or pineapples, or bananas, or corn. It's tilapia. Tilapia farming gained momentum in Honduras in 1983 when the United States began funding research there, as well as training locals on how to farm the fast-growing, easy-to-raise fish. The goal was to add animal protein to Hondurans' bean and corn-based diets and give them a source of income. Today, the country's tilapia farmers range from individuals to families to businesses. Cristobal Barahona Torres is one of them. He began raising tilapia for his large family and for occasional sale more than a dozen years ago when local experts working with the Collaborative Research Support Program in Aquaculture taught him how. Known as CRISP, it is funded by the U.S. Agency for International Development.
Nos enseñaron a comer cosas mejores. No, antes necesitábamos, así como nosotros necesitábamos pescado, ¿verdad? Pues, íbamos al río, así, pero nos costaba conseguir. Hoy no, porque hoy solo agarro la terra y usted miró que un momentito, un solo, saqué un montón de pescado. Entonces ya no sufrimos de querer comernos un pescado.
CRISP experts taught him how to dig a pond and add manure from his livestock to the water to feed a healthy population of algae for the tilapia to eat. They also taught him how to distinguish male and female fish and how to tell when the water doesn't have enough oxygen.
Todo lo que me enseñaron ellos, yo lo hago y me está dando resultados. Esto es de los mejores trabajos que yo he conocido. Qué rentable.
Professor Dan Meyer was one of the people who helped Barahona Torres. Meyer heads the aquaculture program at Honduras' Zamorano University and oversaw USAID's aquaculture program in the Central American country.
Basically, the CRISP program in Honduras has had about almost 25-year history from 83 through 2007. And the initial phase of about 15 years was focused a lot on research and developing the knowledge base. And there was also some important outreach work done then. And then from 99 onward, when Zamorano got involved, it was much more focused on outreach and much less on the research component. The people involved in the first phase generated a huge amount of very valuable information on how to manage tilapia ponds stocked with tilapia, utilizing organic fertilization, chemical fertilizers, different stocking densities, different types of concentrate, the manufactured feeds. They also did a lot of very interesting work on tilapia reproduction. There was a lot of effort put into techniques for breeding tilapia on the farm and producing fingerlings to be stocked into ponds. So there's a lot of very good information generated through 15 years of research activity that later was developed into extension materials and concepts that we use to promote more tilapia culture in country. Nobody knows how many tilapia farmers are in Honduras right now, but we estimate anywhere between 2,000 and 3,000 families are producing tilapia at the small or medium scale in the country.
Luis Fernando Oseguera Larios is one of those medium-scale producers. He began farming tilapia in the 1990s and now sells about 50,000 pounds of it a year to three nearby restaurants and a local buyer. Meyer and his assistants helped him get started. They visited his property and taught him how to design the ponds and how to remove harmful ammonia from the water after it built up from fish waste. They taught him how to reduce the amount of food when the weather is cold because the fish have trouble digesting it. And Meyer advised him to always keep the fish just a little hungry so uneaten food doesn't accumulate in the ponds. Oseguera Larios also traveled to Zamorano University several times for trainings offered by Meyer's team.
He aprendido bastante de mucho para hacer la, como les decía, ser más eficiente en la producción de tilapia, en la mejorar la calidad del agua, en varios aspectos como cómo se hace la reversión de sexo, lo explican ellos a qué edad verdad se debe de hacer, y varios aspectos nos han proporcionado manuales donde todo es cómo empieza desde la producción de alevines hasta lo que es la producción de la tilapia y hasta cómo el fileteado una sola secuencia de todo el proceso de lo que es la tilapia.
By promoting improved tilapia culture in Central America, you're creating new opportunities for people to earn a decent living down here, improve their diets, improve their health, and just have better lives and be more committed to staying where they are. So these USAID dollars or funds, I think, are helping to make Honduras a more hospitable and better place to live.